Morning, Liam. Okay.
Morning.
It's been a big couple of weeks for you, obviously, because I want to reflect on that Wales cap with you. You've had to be patient, but how was it?
Yeah, it was unbelievable. Obviously, sort of a lifetime's work for me, and any player that gets to make their debut for their country. And I was obviously involved in the camps from March up until this month. So I'd obviously spent a lot of time with the group, had a lot of training sessions, experience being on the bench and stuff like that. So from the first day I was there, I wanted to play, and obviously I had to wait a little bit of time. But yeah, it was a great night. It was a good win, obviously, and yeah, really nice to be a part of.
And those few days really have been a highlight, haven't they?
Yeah, obviously a good result in the game I played against Gibraltar, and then a massive one against Croatia, and I think probably our best performance of the campaign and one of our best performances in recent years. So we've put ourselves in a really good position now going into next month, and it's sort of back in our hands now where we win two games, we qualify. So hopefully we can go and achieve that.
What does it do for a player like you coming back to the club with that Welsh cap under your belt?
Yeah, well, obviously it gives you a lot of confidence. I obviously come back on a big high because I've gone and made my debut for my country. So yeah, I don't think playing Leicester was the easiest game to come back into Swansea with. But I think it showed in that performance that even though we lost the game, I think we put in a really good performance. So yeah, it's obviously it was coming back in on a high. So hopefully now we can go into this weekend and we can get back to that feeling.
Bit flat Tuesday, was it?
I think we started the game relatively well. We were on the front foot for most of the first half. I think second half we did go a little bit flat and a little bit wasteful maybe with the ball. And maybe there was a few tired legs, yeah, in the game on Tuesday. I think that probably comes from playing a team like Leicester on Saturday, and we probably spent more time in that game without the ball than any game in the last 3 years or however long. I'm not sure on the statistics or anything like that, but if I was to guess, like being in the game, we were made to run a fair bit more than what we used to off the ball. So yeah, maybe there was a few tired legs, and we did feel like the game was there for us, but it obviously wasn't meant to be. So I think it's just about bouncing back this weekend now and getting another 3 points on the board.
I mean, I've seen you score goals. You love scoring goals. But for Wales, we played slightly deeper, and you seem to thrive on that as well. So are you happy to play wherever, or have you got a preferred sort of position?
Well, I've always grown up being a number nine, and I've played a lot of my youth Wales career out wide. So I'm pretty comfortable. I feel like I'm pretty versatile. I'd like to think people can see that from the positions I've played, even in the Championship. I've played through the middle up front. I've played wide and I've played a little bit deeper, but I just want to be on the pitch. So whatever job I'm given, I'm going to try and carry out to the best of my ability. And yeah, hopefully I can play well wherever I'm played.
And given the life of a footballer, you've always got contracts on your mind. I mean, yours is up in the summer. You might be in a Euros in the summer. I mean, you've got a bit of a double aim, I suppose, for this season, really.
Yeah, it's obviously a big year. It's like, obviously, like you mentioned with my contract. So I've got a point to prove still. And obviously the Euros are coming, so I want to keep, hopefully we can qualify this month or next month. And I can put in performances to show that I deserve to be in the squad. So yeah, it's obviously a big year. There's no denying that. But I'm just trying to take it game by game here with Swansea now going into the next break. And then when the break comes, if I'm in the squad, we'll look at Armenia first and then Turkey. So I think it's important for me not to look too far ahead and just to concentrate on what's right in front of me. So yeah, that's what I'm going to do right now.
But you know, you said yourself, it's a big year, possibly the biggest you've had given everything that's happened.
Yeah, I think so. obviously off the back of a good season or half a season last year, after I came into the team, it was important for me to build on it. And I'm getting regular minutes now. I've got a few assists and a goal to my name. At the minute, it's not really going for me in front of goal or whatever, but I think it's about staying patient a little bit and just trying to get myself in the right areas, and hopefully it'll turn for me, and I'll start getting them numbers again in front of goal. I think me and Pat have been talking about it, that we've probably been the ones with lesser chances in front of goal, if you'd like to say so. Yeah, we're just trying to stay patient and keep getting ourselves in good areas, and hopefully it'll click for us.
And I know you said earlier you used to listen to the radio. Maybe you don't know, but I'm sure you read stuff as well. And you're linked sometimes with other clubs. In fact, Blackburn in the last few weeks. What does that do to your brain when you see that? You take any notice or what?
No, not really. I think when you're linked to other clubs, it's a little bit of recognition that you might be doing well, especially if they're in the same league or similar position to you, that they are, they could, well, I'm not sure if they were, but they could be looking at a player like me. So yeah, but I don't really take any notice of it. I don't really read much. I get told it, I get sent it by friends and stuff to see if there's any truth in it. But like I say all the time, I'm playing for my home club. I've played here all my life, and there's nothing that a player would want more than to play for the club he supports. So yeah, I'm at the club I want to be at, so hopefully I can keep doing that.
It was obviously a lot of upheaval in the summer, a lot of players coming in, 13 I think for the first team. In terms of the depth of the squad, do you feel like there's enough quality there to cope with those challenges that you've outlined there?
Yeah, 100%. We obviously had a bigger squad before all of our injuries. We were really unlucky at the start of the season with some of the injuries we had. You have Joe, Gino and Woody, three big players in our squad. Gino had just started to get in the starting 11, and he was obviously having a big effect on games with his pace and stuff like that. And we were really getting a lot of joy with him. So that was really unfortunate. I think obviously Joe speaks for himself. If he's Joe Allen, you want to have him in your squad every week if you can. So hopefully we'll have him back as soon as possible. And then Woody as well. He was a massive player for us last season. So yeah, I still think we have the depth in the squad, because there's not, I think pretty much everyone has championship experience. So we definitely have that quality and that depth. So I think it's just about showing it.
Michael said, you know, despite being injured, Joe has had a really, really big impact on the squad behind the scenes. Is that something you've seen?
Yeah, I ask him a lot of questions regularly. Having the career he's had, there's probably no other player that you'd rather go to and ask for advice than him. You obviously have Noughts, Grimesy and Jay that are there as well. So we have a lot of lads to fall back on and to ask questions. And then to ask advice too. So we're lucky to have them types of characters in the dressing room, I think. But obviously Joe being out, he sees it from a different perspective, being on the side of the pitch. So it's probably nicer to go to him at the minute, because he obviously sees it in a different sense to us when we're on the pitch playing. So yeah, of course he's going to have a big effect on the squad, whether he's in it or not, because he obviously knows his stuff.
And what's the mood like at the moment? Because Tuesday it felt quite frustrating. Has that been kind of reflected on the training ground?
I think the mood's good. We've been in worse positions and worse runs than we are now. I think the mood didn't dip after Leicester. I feel like everyone feels like we put in a really good performance against them. It's just that they're probably the best championship team that the league's seen in years. And it's quite evident from the players they have in their squad. I don't think it's hardly changed since they come down. So yeah, I think many people have said that you'd expect them to go straight back up. Probably they're going to win the league, I think. So yeah, the mood didn't dip after that. It was obviously a frustrating night on Tuesday. We felt like we should have won the game. we had enough to win the game. The main thing is we can't really let it affect us and go into Saturday in a dip mood or sulking, if you'd like. Not that we ever are like that, because we're not a group who does that. It's about keeping our spirits high, keeping positive on the training pitch and being confident going into the weekend.
Do you think the squads perhaps might have learned something did you learn anything about the squad going up against such a talented opposition on Saturday that perhaps you didn't know before? In terms of where they are, I mean.
Yeah, obviously, like I said, they're probably the best championship team in years, so you can learn a lot playing against them. I think we did a really good job of probably frustrating them. And our defensive shape, I thought, was really good, and I think we did. They obviously had chances. They're going to have chances in every game they play this season, probably. I thought they used the ball when they got into them areas really, really well. I think we can look at that game and learn from it. And probably in a game like Tuesday, where we were the ones being frustrated when they were sitting in a deep block, that when we do get in those areas, it's about being clinical and ruthless and making sure we kill teams off. So hopefully that's a stage that we can get to.
Cheers, Liam. All the best Saturday.
Cheers. Thank you.